Hey YouTube, so I went to AOAA with Infidel Jeepers of Maryland last month-ish, and so anyway, we were on the Twister Trail and Barney Rubble Trail while we were there, and this is it. And we just hit 15 subscribers. Thank you for subscribing, and please subscribe if you haven't. And I'll talk a little bit about YouTube while I'm in the video. I'm also going to talk about the trail in this video. Obviously, the channel is oriented toward a vlog, meaning that it's more like about my life and more about what we're doing and like where we're going, and hopefully people enjoy watching like what my hobbies and enjoy watching what we're doing. So it won't be just like all just straight out Jeep videos, but there will, you know, there'll be quite a few Jeep videos because we take the Jeep out a lot, obviously. So anyway, the first part of this trail is really, really kind of greenish, but you can see like right there there's like a kind of a little bit of a dip going down. For the most part, the Twister Trail is very easy to do going downhill. You can get a stock vehicle and go down it. Easy peasy. The driver might be a little bit scared because, you know, it's a little bit off canter and stuff, but easily you can get a stock vehicle down it. You might even be able to get like a car down it. Going up it, that is like a different story. It's it can get wet, it can get loose, it can get muddy. It can be a little bit of a pain for a stock vehicle to come up it, not because of clearance issues, just because of traction issues. And when I say stock, I mean like one without lockers or anything like that. Although most likely you probably can easily make it up this trail without lockers. Now, if you see there's a side by side in front of me, and I pause for a second, it's way ahead of me. You're gonna notice it like more when we get closer. When you're leading a group, you need to be very aware of other vehicles on the trail. If you see anything move at all, you need to kind of stop and like figure out like, are they getting out of the way? Are we getting out of the way? Because you can see like right here on the side, there's all these like kind of big open spots. And if he didn't have a spot to get out of the way, then I would have had to figure out a way to get all the Jeeps behind me in these spots next to me so he could get around me. But fortunately, you know, he was cool and he just pulled over and let us go by. So that was excellent of him. Typically, what I've seen is like the ATVs and the side-by-sides and stuff, they typically get over for the Jeeps because they know that it takes much longer for the Jeeps to get between trees and stuff because they're so much bigger and so much harder to find spots for us. That they usually get out of our way like 90% of the time. It's really rare for them to want to sit in the middle of the trail and expect the Jeeps to get out of the trail. So anyway, so this is part of the trail where, like I said, it would be a little bit harder to go up. And as you can see, you know, it's mostly like loose dirt, it's ruts. Right here you can see there's actually a pretty big, you know, drop off on the right hand side and a large rock. So, you know, if you're in a stock vehicle and you're trying to come up this, it would probably be just a little bit challenging. Going down it, though, no problems. So we're going to continue going down this, and when we get to the bottom of this, it's going to turn into the Barney Rubble Trail. If you turn to the left, and that's what we're going to do, we're going to turn left and go up the Barney Rubble Trail. So anyway, a little bit about YouTube, just because we have time in the video to talk about it, and we have 15 subscribers, which is awesome, and a lot of the people that watch these videos are actually from Facebook that know me. So anyway, a lot of people probably say, you know, how do I make comments in the bottom of the video? How do I subscribe to a channel or whatever? They don't know anything about this YouTube stuff, and like, they think they have to have some kind of special YouTube account. That's not true at all. A YouTube account is a Google account, which is a Gmail account. If you have like a an email address, and the email address says like @gmail.com, you just log into YouTube, you put that in, and then you're like whammo jammo, like that is your YouTube account. It's the same difference. So almost everybody on Facebook probably has a Gmail account, so almost everybody on Facebook has a YouTube account. It just probably half of them haven't bothered with trying to log into YouTube because they don't actually know that they have one. You know, well, surprise, like you have a YouTube account, you don't know it. So anyway, so that's the first thing. The second thing is, you know, we hit 15 subscribers, which is awesome. You know, some of the questions come around like, well, what does it mean to have subscribers? What does it do for you? That kind of stuff. So within YouTube, you have channels. This is a channel you're watching. Channel is typically about something or other. My channel is a vlog, meaning it kind of follows me around. And, you know, I display some of my hobbies on it. I display what I'm doing. And you can see these guys are just parked. They're not actually on the trail, which is cool that they parked off the trail, not on the trail. So we're going to make the left here, and we're going to go up Barney Rubble. And the first part of Barney Rubble is very green. The nice part about this part of Barney Rubble is it has a little bit of everything. There's sections in it that have streams. There's a section of Barney that is kind of like uphill climbs. There's rocks on Barney. So this part right here where those ATVs are on the right And technically, I don't think they're supposed to be there, but I'm not going to say anything because they're like way, way up there. I'm not going to, you know, chase them down. I think that technically this is a blue, and I don't think that they want the side-by-sides on blues. But, I don't know. I'm not going to, like, police them or whatever. But there's some people up there that probably shouldn't be. Anyway, they may not actually go up to the rocky part. I don't know. Maybe it's cool. Whatever. I'm not gonna, the right-hand side is normally, like, a stream, so you do this, like, kind of cool stream crossing and everything. To get back to YouTube. So the thing with, like, subscribers and stuff, so you have this thing called a channel, and you're obviously watching a channel. For the person that actually is posting the videos, YouTube unlocks the features of the channel, typically based on how many subscribers I have, plus possibly how many views they've had within that channel. So, you know, for somebody like me, when I have 15 subscribers, I really don't really have any fancy features on my channel. But as I hit certain thresholds, then all of a sudden, like, additional things appear that I can do on my channel that weren't there before. Like, so for instance, when I hit 100 subscribers, at that point I can actually get a URL from YouTube. So then, like, the top of the URL would be something like youtube.com/quarterly, instead of having, like, the big fancy number up there. When you hit 1,000 subscribers, at that point you can monetize, meaning, like, you can put an advertisement at the beginning of the video or whatever, or there you could put, like, a little banner ad, like, across the bottom, which nobody really wants to watch these things. But anyway, like, that's the 1,000 threshold. There is, like, another threshold, I think, where you get a community tab, which is like a comments thing. So that's good that they're making the right-hand turn there, and they decided not to make the left. That's what the subscribers do for, like, the YouTuber. Like, it, the more of them they get, the more features get unlocked on their channel. And unfortunately, you know, the hardest thing is getting started. And, you know, when you're getting started, because they kind of take the tools away from you, it makes it a little bit harder to get started. So, I've heard people say that, like, you know, even when they're trying to do monetization and stuff, like, it takes, like, 6 months before they have enough subscribers to even get, like, a dollar back from YouTube or anything. Like it's a long, long step, set of steps to get there. So anyway, thank you for subscribing. It's totally awesome and stuff. This is the Barney Rubble Trail that we're on. This is right where it starts to become difficult, like I've said before. So it splits three ways. The left side they call Barney Rubble. The middle, I think, is Bam Bam. And the far right is Pebbles. No, it's the other way. I think the middle is Pebbles and the right is Bam Bam. So anyway, though, I have videos of me going up all three ways. We are going to go up the left-hand side, which is the easy side, and or easier side, let's just say, and or milder side. The right-hand side is the harder side, and the center, what we discovered, what isn't really, like, fully, you couldn't find a way to actually go up the center. We went partially up the center, and then we got to a point where we had to either go left or right. But basically, it's just how big do you want the rocks to be that you go up, and how challenging do you want it to be. And so we're going to run up it. I did talk about money a little bit because a lot of people, just probably heard, oh, he's going to get money from YouTube. Well, you don't really get a whole lot of money from YouTube, to tell you the truth, even on these big giant monster videos. So the way the money works or whatever is they put advertisements on YouTube, like in front of the video or in the middle of the video or after the video or little banners. And basically, you know, when you get past 1,000 subscribers, YouTube basically splits the money with you. So you get, like, 50% of the advertising, they get 50% of the advertising, and they're giving you the advertising money because you're spending the time to make the content, and then you're giving them, like, the advertising money because, like, they're YouTube and they own everything, right? It's Google. They're providing the servers, the streaming, like, all that kind of stuff. So it's a fair split, and it sounds like you're going to make a lot of money. It's some money, but it's not crazy. The weird thing is, like, the money that they do give out is based on where the advertisement is. Like, is advertisement in China? Is advertisement in Canada? Is advertisement in the United States? And then how valuable is the advertisement to them? But in the end, it ends up being, like, somewhere between, like, $1 and $4 for every 1,000 views. Like, that's basically the magic number, ish. So, 1,000 views of ads. So if you get, like, your average video that, is 10 minutes in length and it has, like, say, one advertisement at the beginning of it, and then you go and you see the bottom, like, on views, because anybody can see how many views it has. If it has, like, let's say, 1,000,000 views, then that video probably was worth, like, maybe $1,000 or maybe $2,000 at the most. However, the YouTuber does have the ability to, like, you know, cover the entire video with ads. They could put ads like every 5 minutes if they wanted to or something stupid, which would make it so, you know, that same video would be worth more money, but nobody would watch it because it would be full of ads. So there, that's your like kind of like YouTube 101. So anyway, we're working on this vlog, and we're trying to make it awesome. We're trying to make content, and it's going to get better. You're going to see, like, you know, I have unsteady hands with a camera. Well, we're going to get a gimbal. You know, there's going to be more B-roll because people like the B-roll. We're working hard to try to make it better. You know, the first step was just getting a camera. We have a Canon M50 mirrorless camera. You know, so if you look at like the compare this to say the video footage that we did when we did SOB, you'll see that on SOB there was a lot of parallax, meaning like if you look at the left side and right hand side of the screens, like everything was like really warped looking because we were using like a really old GoPro that didn't have any of the delinearization capabilities or whatever. So anyway, we're working on getting it better, but you know, it's just step by step, and you know, you start somewhere. And, you know, our goal is basically to retire in an RV and travel across the United States and see family and stuff and make YouTube videos, you know, and work part-time. So that's kind of like the long-term plan that we have here. And, you know, this video turned more into a vlog than it did a jeeping video, but you did get a chance to see Barney Rubble. Like I said, this left-hand side is the easy side. So when you get up here and you get off the Barney Rubble trail, you could make a left-hand turn, and that will take you right back to U-Joint Tree. Like, hypothetically, if you were wanting to go down Twister again and make this whole loop, like, again and over and over again and over again, the left would take you right back to where we started at. If you make a right-hand turn here, the right-hand turn will take you to the M Trail. M will be on your left, and then to the right will be the Barney Rubble Trail that is broken into Bam Bam Pebbles and Barney Rubble. So please like and subscribe. The left side here, you can see the two signs, that's M, and the right is Barney Rubble.